My story might be a little different. I'm hoping it's on the better side of everything, but I want you as someone who truly understands this to help explain where I'm at right now. So 2 years ago, it'll be 2 years in June, I went home, I think the week before Father's Day, spent some time outside with my mom and my dad. We went on a bike ride. I came home, and on the farm, although they don't really farm anymore, he still has some farm stuff. He had some big old hay bales covered by a tarp. And my dad asked me to go fix the tarp, which had like blown over. And I drove the side-by-side four-wheeler ATV out there. Was pretty careful to not walk through the tall grass, but obviously I made some contact with it. And I think I was wearing shorts, just kind of oblivious mostly to my risk. I climbed up on the bales. I fixed the tarp, got back down, went about my day. Somewhere in there, I assume, is when I got a tick on me, at least one, who knows.
Right.
And I didn't make a point to check myself to make sure there were no ticks. A few days later, only after the fact did I think about or remember that it seemed like one night in bed, I found something on me and I didn't really think much about it. And then one day in the shower, I saw something drop that looked unusual that might have been a tick. I don't know. Right. But about a week after that, about 10 days after that weekend, I had this really minor headache that stayed. I'd never had a headache stay for like 4 days. But by about the fourth day, I thought I was getting a fever, but then I didn't feel like I had a fever. I was going up and down. And then by the weekend, I had what I've later heard is called brain fog, or nothing.
Yeah.
I couldn't concentrate on anything. My memory, I'd go for a very simple memory, normal, and it just wasn't there. I couldn't get it. And eventually I went into urgent care, but I went in not even thinking about Lyme disease. They were asking me questions about if I saw any spots on my body. I guess I hadn't looked that closely, because the next day, the next morning after my shower, after a terrible night, not being able to sleep well, I noticed a big old bullseye in my back in different spots elsewhere.
Oh, wow.
And went back into urgent care. So I never actually got officially diagnosed with a test, because I was leaving town and they put me on I think it was doxycycline, a couple of weeks, and I immediately started to feel better. The spot went away within a matter of days. It was kind of crazy because it was so big, and then it was suddenly.
Yeah.
So exactly. So based on my story, Dr. Tom, is there any doubt that I had Lyme disease, and am I actually cured? Because I've told people I'm cured of it, but maybe that's not true.
Well, you know, Curt, the thing with the bullseye rash, or what's more properly called an erythema migrans rash, we see that with the rash, not everybody gets a bullseye, but the rash is, it's sort of like a red splotch and stuff. That's consistent with the Lyme rash. And, you know, unless you're living in somewhere like Hawaii, you know, or maybe north, very, very north in Alaska, that is what we call pathognomonic for Lyme disease, meaning that seals the diagnosis. You don't need to go and get blood tests and anything. You know, you really should start the treatment early. And what happens is the earlier the treatment, the more likely you are to have a good outcome. And so, which is, I think, super important, because all the studies we have show that once you're about 4 months out from infection to the part where you start treatment, it's really hard to cure. We don't really know what does it. But when you get it right away, when that rash first comes out and you take definitive action and get that taken care of, you have a really good possibility that a shorter course of treatment will work, and that also, you know, that you may have a long-term cure. Now, the other thing is, we know from some research out of Johns Hopkins that, you know, I guess if we back up for a second, if you look at Lyme disease overall, people are talking about persister forms and stationary forms and even these biofilms and cysts. These things that are around for a period, you know, that make Lyme stick around in your body longer, like, you know, so basically all of these are protective mechanisms when the Lyme spirochete, the bacteria that causes most of the symptoms, is trying to attack you. If we go after it with our immune system or with antibiotics or herbs, we actually can, it'll go into this dormant protected state for when the environment in you is better. We know that early on that doesn't happen as much. So the earlier the treatment, the better. But the research out of Hopkins has also shown that these forms may be able to actually live that way in the tick. And it's possible that the tick can actually, you know, essentially infect you with a persistent form of Lyme right away. Now, this is relatively new information, but clinically it makes sense. We see that 70 or 80% of people who get treated early on and they get their 3 or 4 weeks, like right out of the get-go, like you did, those people are 70 to 80% of them are going to do really well. But there's a small group of them that end up getting these persistent symptoms. And so those people may have been sort of infected with what they're calling early, late persistent Lyme disease, rather than the way we would usually think of getting it is we, you know, you got bit, your symptoms slowly, slowly crept up. And then by the time you actually get a diagnosis, it's been 4 or 6 months after the tick bite. So there certainly is hope that, you know, in your scenario that it is cured. And, you know, we think we can cure it at any stage. It's just the longer it's been, the harder it gets, you know.